In my Discord server, we do a monthly build challenge where we have a theme, a location, and certain guidelines to follow for the build. It's open to anyone who wants to participate, and at the end of each month, we have a week-long vote to determine the winner. And the winners will receive absolutely nothing. Except their builds will be showcased in videos like this. So, yeah, congratulations. So the challenges are set up and ran by my administrator, my second in command of the Discord server, Commonwealth Charlie. He completely manages and runs the challenges by himself, so I really appreciate all of his hard work in the server. But this is the first challenge, which was at Taffington Boathouse, with a theme of rebirth and renew, where you had to turn the existing house into something new, you know, some sort of functioning structure. Basically, you couldn't scrap this house and build whatever you wanted. You had to turn the house into something. And the third place winner of the monthly build challenge is Proton Rads. He's actually a moderator on my server, but I did not participate in voting, so there is no conflict of interest, just to get that out of the way. Now, I'm going to briefly show the parts of these builds that stood out to me the most, but all the links to their videos will be in the description in case you want to check out the full builds and hear commentary from the actual builders, which I highly recommend because I do these build review videos mainly because people ask, but also because I think they're really good and deserve some traffic. So I only show certain parts that I really like and want to point out, and then hope that people will go over to their channels and check out the rest because, like I said, there's a lot more to them and they're all really good. So this one by Proton Rads is a Raider settlement, which I've never done before. I need to do one of those builds. But my favorite part of this is the upstairs area. So he's like the Raider boss of this gang, and so the upstairs and the roof is all like his workshop, his bedroom, all that. And I just love the decorations because it looks like it's all just kind of thrown together. You know, there's a tire underneath the table and robot parts over here. It's just like very Raider-esque. You know, he did a good job capturing the Raider feel of this build. Sweetheart, the door is at the bottom of the stairs. I mean, you're close, but just, yeah, oh, she'll figure it out. I just love the blood stains on the floor, even right next to the bed. It's like, I could clean that up, but I'm not going to because I'm a Raider. Keep it going. I believe in you. You're going to walk through that wall one day. I know it. But this is the coolest part to me, the roof area, which is like a small part of the build too, but it just stands out because I wouldn't have thought to do this. And I love when people build into the existing structures without trying to repair them. Like I would have probably closed this whole thing off and made it an actual attic. But what he did with this workshop area looks like something that would be found in the game. So great job, Proton, really good work. And second place goes to My Smee. Or is it My Smy? No, it's definitely not my. It's not my, is it? No, it's me. It's me. Either way, congratulations. This build is really cool. I really like the guard post right here because it's a mixture of structures. You got the capsule mixed with the metal pieces, and I think it turned out really well because you don't normally see stuff like that. And look at this. They used airplane pieces to make it look like an airplane crashed into the house, and that's why there's a hole in the roof, which I thought was just genius, man. Very creative. Like, I would have never thought, my brain would have never gone there. And I'm pretty sure that's what the intent is, right? I don't picture any other scenario, but either way, it looked really badass. And I wanted to point out these turret stands, or whatever you want to call them, these turret towers. Ooh, turret towers. Yeah, okay. Because I love them. I love them so much that I will scream. I don't care. I love these turrets. I love them so much. I'm going to steal them. No, we're going to run away together to one of my builds, and that's where you will find them. This general trader area is pretty badass. I love how open it is. You know, it's not closed off like a normal store. They have a nice little fence around. Oh, hey, little doggy. How's it going, little puppy? I know it's a full-grown dog, but that's not fun to say. Oh, how's it going, little full-grown dog? No, it's a puppy. Anyways, what was I saying? Oh, the store. Yeah, they did such a good job on this because it just looks different from something that you would normally see. I really like the idea of the crops being underneath this scaffolding area. It just looks secure to me. I don't know. It's a nice little touch. And I love walkways, especially in this kind of environment, because it makes sense that they would have, if they're going to build something, they're going to have ways to get around very quickly in case some shit goes down. And this is a really cool view. So you can see the airplane that they have over there. I think they turned that into some kind of shop. Definitely check that out in the full build video on their channel. And look at the turrets. All cozied up in their towers. Not a care in the world.
I love you.
But yeah, I imagine there's not much that you can do with this airplane piece up here. So they just threw down a couch, which looks awesome. And then it just connects to the backside of their walkway. And they just, again, just a quick way to get around just in case something happens. And I love the view up here. They did such a good job on this build. I'm not showing the inside of the house, but definitely check out the full build. There's so much more to it. And the winner of the first cordless VII monthly build challenge is Crazy Ike Gaming. Now I'm getting real tired. I'm gonna be honest with you guys. I'm getting real tired of reviewing Crazy Ike's builds because he's starting to make me look bad. Yeah, no, I'm on to you, Crazy Ike. I'm on to you. I see what you're doing. I'm watching you. Yeah, no. I see you coming into my server and showing off builds like this. I don't even want to show it. I don't want to cut the video now. Like, yeah, go watch on his channel. Now he won, it's good. But I can't. No, I got to take you through it. I mean, first of all, look at that tower. Look at that guard tower. Like, holy shit, that looks good. And see, here's the thing. He knows where things should go. Like the guard post that we just looked at. And this building is in the perfect location. And then not just structures, but also how things are decorated. Like, look at the shelf in the back corner over there. It's everything's just kind of perfectly set up on the walls with the right amount of decorations, the right amount of posters. You don't have too much, or they all just kind of flow together. And that's the only way that I can describe it. He just knows how things should look and where they should go. It sounds like I'm talking out of my ass, but it's just hard to explain. I wish I had a build that I could show you that's like the opposite of knowing where things should go, but I don't want to put anybody on blast because that'd be kind of messed up, wouldn't it? Like, here's what you shouldn't do. And look at this. Look at this. He's making some kind, his own kind of boat with a car and whatever the fuck that is. I don't know, but it looks awesome, whatever it is. And just no criticism with all the decorations and everything. It looks great. I do need to know what shelves those are. Like, where did you get those shelves? The bottom ones, like those. I need to know. Can someone tell me? I mean, I could easily ask him myself, but it's a pride thing at this point. And look at this bathroom. Like, it's kind of a slap in the face. Like, he should know that I'm not good with bathrooms, and then he just casually shows this. Like, look how nice this looks, you know? And then, I don't know. To me, I don't know. It's kind of a low blow. It's kind of a low blow, but whatever. We'll just keep on going. And now here we go. My favorite part of the whole build is this upstairs bar area. So we need a mod list, okay? Because where'd you get those blinking lights? I have some similar, but they don't look as good. So we need a mod list. That's a requirement. Okay, Crazy Ike, have your people call my people and don't forget the mod list. But this looks amazing. And a big part of it is the way that he does his lighting. I mean, I know the decorations and how he placed everything down, of course, sure. But lighting plays a big part. And that's one thing that I noticed with his build is that he really knows how to capture the right lighting to make something that would look, you know, somewhat just ordinary to really make it stand out. I mean, I could talk about this build all day, and everyone who submitted did a really good job. So congratulations to the winners of this month, and thank you to everyone who participated. We actually had a lot of builds to look at, which was awesome, and I hope we continue to get more people involved. So as I mentioned before, we're going to be doing this every month. So if you want to join in, or at least come chat with a pretty awesome Fallout community, click the link to my Discord server that's in the description. I'm on there a good bit, so come say hi.